I said that the COVID-19 crisis, a crisis that's more socioeconomic than health in terms of its impact on society, I said that this vaccine rollout, you know, by corrupt corporations like Pfizer, Moderna, Johnson & Johnson, et cetera, I said that this was going to be a problem that would unravel and get bigger and bigger over time. And that's what it looks like is happening. If we look at this article from RT, Massachusetts congressman tests positive for COVID-19 after getting two shots of Pfizer vaccine. So he got both shots. He tested negative before the Biden inauguration, and then he got tested again. Now he's positive. So now he's in self-isolation. And it says down here, the vaccine requires two shots administered several weeks apart and sometime afterwards to fully kick in. And none of them claim to offer full protection. So it's possible to be infected even after both doses. So what is the point of this vaccine? What people don't understand is once you get the vaccine, it doesn't mean you can't get infected by COVID-19. You can, and you could even infect others even after being vaccinated. The whole point of a vaccine is to prepare your body ahead of time to defeat a disease that your body normally cannot defeat on its own. But that's not the case with COVID-19. The truth about COVID-19 is that if you're healthy, you have no underlying health conditions, if you're not old and frail, you can get COVID-19 and not even realize you have it. Your body is more than capable of defeating it on its own. It'll defeat it, it'll build up antibodies that will enable it to defeat it again if exposed, you know, within a relatively short period of time. Your body will be able to consistently defeat COVID-19. The whole point of a vaccine, in theory, is that you would give it to people in society who are vulnerable, who might get infected with COVID-19, and their body on its own might not be able to overcome the virus. That's who you would give it to. This concept of herd immunity makes no sense, especially in terms of COVID-19. This is a virus that's gone all around the world several times over now. It's in every corner of the globe. Here in Thailand, there's been less than 80 people who have died from COVID-19 in well over a year. And that's not to minimize the deaths of anybody, but relatively speaking, the socioeconomic impact has been so much harder on Thailand than the health impact. And why are we going to rush Thailand as a nation? Why should Thailand rush to give these vaccines out to people until we are totally sure that they are safe, they are effective, and they are absolutely necessary? Because why else do it if that's not the case? So I think people in the opposition trying to rush the government to do the vaccinations as fast as possible and to use any vaccine on the market is highly irresponsible, especially, you know, it seems the opposition doesn't even realize that the technology to make the Pfizer vaccine is completely different than the AstraZeneca vaccine. And the technology used for the Sinovac vaccine is completely different than the Pfizer and AstraZeneca vaccine. So this isn't like picking a brand of soap off the shelf of 7-Eleven. This is very complex, and there's a lot of considerations that go into it. And I think the Thai opposition, for them not to understand that or not to include that as part of their argument, just shows how immature and irresponsible they are. I just want to point out one last thing about the vaccines. If you have a disease that most people cannot overcome on their own, then getting a vaccine makes perfect sense. If that vaccine is proven to help you build a defense against that disease. If it is a disease that the vast majority of the population can overcome on their own without any help at all, without any medical attention at all, then shutting society down and wait, holding our breath until the vaccines are online, vaccines that obviously don't even work, what was the point of that? As I've said, you know, they did this with the swine flu in 2009. It was not that there was no swine flu, but they purposefully took a flu and they turned it into a crisis and they capitalized on it. They made billions and they got caught. They got caught lying about everything. They got caught with financial ties with the people at the World Health Organization to help pressure governments to declare a pandemic and to induce them into buying products from these pharmaceutical corporations. And they're doing it again with COVID-19, but just on a much larger industrialized global scale. So I just thought I would point this out. People should look into what vaccinations are, okay? And if it's a I'm not saying that COVID-19 is completely harmless. If you're old and frail or you have underlying health conditions, it's dangerous. And you have to be careful and you have to protect yourself. If the vaccine could be proven that you could give it to these vulnerable people and it would protect them, then that would make sense to give them the vaccine. If it's a vaccine that you get and you could still get infected and infect others with it, and your body is already capable of overcoming the virus anyway, then it's why take it? Why take it? The answer here is to isolate vulnerable people, to ensure that they have access to critical care, and to develop a safe, effective vaccine for them, to protect them, to build their body's defense up to a virus that everyone else in society can easily overcome. So that's the video for today. If you don't like my COVID-19 coverage, I'm sorry. This thing where I point out the abuse and corruption of pharmaceutical corporations is something that I've done for years and I will continue to do. And no number of comments or emails is going to change my mind about that. The prospect of a system that has lied about everything from wars to the swine flu in 2009 is not going to suddenly start telling us the truth here in 2021 about COVID-19. So just keep all of that in mind. To my patrons that make these videos possible on a daily basis, thank you so much. Please like and share the video if you thought it was useful. Think about subscribing. It really helps the channel grow. And to everyone helping me everywhere with absolutely everything, I couldn't do this without that support. I appreciate that so much. And as always, thank you for watching.